The essence of life comes alive when you live it slow, live it full, right till the edge of the light. Today, we're here near Chalohi, in a sprawling village in the lap of the Dholadars, poppy fields, young river streams. It's a true artist's delight. You walk a mile here, you'll find a desolate train station. You walk a mile there, you'll find an art gallery. Another mile somewhere and you'll find a pottery studio. And one more mile away, you'll come at the edge of a tea plantation. No wonder why they call it a colony for the artists. Welcome to Andretta. Hardly a few minutes on the saddle of the bike and you've reached Andretta, thanks to its close proximity to Chalohi. First up, we arrive at the Andretta Pottery. It's situated right next to a small nala, as they call it here. Nestled among lush green trees and moss everywhere, it's almost a perfect setting here at India's oldest pottery studio. It has a small shop where you can purchase some fine pottery. They have a guided tour on offer and a terracotta museum within the premises. But the most exciting thing that you can do here is take up a small pottery making session. Having carved an amateurish bowl with some help, it is time to say goodbye to the pottery studio. And right when I'm heading to the next spot for the day, I come across this deserted train station of Panchrukhi. It's an old narrow gauge line that has been left abandoned along the years. And one can only imagine what this scenic little junction might look back in its heyday. I get back on the saddle and ride just about a couple of kilometers further to arguably the most famous place here, the Shobha Singh Art Gallery. It's a nice sunny day in the midst of a long monsoon season here in Andretta, so I thought a visit to the art gallery is only a must. Now, it is not like any other art gallery out there, and the main reason is because this place is still a home to the family of Shobha Singh to this day. It's fairly easy to spot the gallery as it's on the only main road that the village has. A big blue gate stands at the entrance, after which you are met with a plethora of greens right till the art gallery itself. Now, if you don't know about Shobha Singh, here's a brief. He's a well-renowned Indian artist and sculptor who resided in Andretta for about 40 years. Some of his most famous works include Sohini Mahiwal and Heer Ranjha. And he was conferred with Padma Shri along a host of other accolades in the 80s. An hour spent in the art gallery and the museum is enough for you to get an insight into the life of this man. It has been quite an artsy day here today. And to be honest, the sun has been quite strong the whole time. There's only one thing on my mind now. Thank you. very reason why I set my base at Chalohi, the Avakhad. To be around the sound of the ever-flowing khad, to sunbathe around its fertile pastures, and to take a dip on a sunny day. That is all I yearn for. What a beautiful day it has been. I started out on a creative note, making pottery at the studio. I came across a neglected but equally stunning spot. Explored an art gallery, got to know about an artist and his life, and to top it all up, enjoyed a serene dip in the ravine flowing nearby. I guess there's not much to do now, other than sit in the backyard of my homestay here with a bowl of popcorn and a cup of coffee and watch the light of the sun slowly fade away. The essence of life comes alive when you live it slow, live it full, right till the edge of the light.